नमस्कार, आई एम कमांडर अशोक राउत, नेशनल प्रेसिडेंट फॉर नेशनल एजुकेशन कमिटी EPS 95. फ्रेंड्स, आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर फ्यू थिंग्स विथ यू. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, आई वेलकम द गुजरात टीम, आवर NAC's नेशनल सेक्रेटरी किरीट गोहिल जी. He and his 12 friends who came from Gujarat all the way to Buldhana to congratulate and encourage our agitators, our people, those who are doing fast hunger strike. I am really grateful to them for the gesture. Second thing, lot of phone calls are coming and people are asking why there is no mention of EPS 95 in the budget, or why there is no allocation or even indication. Let me tell you, and I can understand your anger, I can definitely understand your feelings, but let me tell you, our problem is heard by the highest authority, that is the Prime Minister. On 4th March 2020, by the initiative of Honorable Hema Malini ji, Honorable Prime Minister had given us patient hearing and he promised us that all four demands of ours will be fulfilled. Whether it is 7,500 plus DA minimum pension, medical facilities, then those who are not in the gambit of EPS 95, they should be taken or they should be rewarded accordingly, and also the higher pension issue. So friends, when it comes from that level, there is no iota of doubt that it will be done. To support this, we have started nationwide campaign of contacting the who's who of India, including all MPs, all respectable MPs, all respectable CBT members, and also the trade union leaders. Everybody we are contacting. We are contacting even, you know, other leaders who are, you know, and everybody is with us. Be it a political leadership, be it a spiritual leadership of the country, be it is the social leadership of the country. Everybody is with us, everybody's blessings are with us, because our problem is genuine and it will be solved within this budget session. So please don't worry. You don't have reason to, you know, get confused. In the same way, we had met Honorable Bhartruhari Mahatab Sahab, MP Katak, who is the leader of Parliamentary Committee on Labour. There 31 MPs committee is being set up for all the issues of concerning labour and EPFO. We met him, we presented him our report, our committee's report of NAC, and which he accepted. The report is very good report, and it shows how our demands can be fulfilled within our money. You also know that on 26th January 2020, that is last year, we have withdrawn all our agitations on request of Honorable Labour Minister. Only Buldhana agitation, which is chain hunger strike, is going on symbolically, and all other agitations are withdrawn. So therefore, there is no support to any agitation presently going on in the country. There are people who are confused between different, you know, agitations. Let me make it very clear, we are not supporting any agitation in the country which is going on presently. We are not politically motivated people, we are social people. At the last, I would say, we are conducting Central Working Committee's meeting on 30th April, and the general convention, national convention on 1st May, that is Kamgar Din, Labour's Day, the place and other things will be told to you later on, but this is what we are planning. And at last, I would like to reassure you that 7,500 pension and medical facilities and other demands will be fulfilled within this parliamentary session. Thank you. Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu.